ladies and gentlemen, one and all. Today, I wanted to record this because I wanted to share my experiences which I have been experiencing for last 20 or 25 years. It's like struggling towards trying to explain what is it that I can do to convince someone, or you know, having that kind of conviction or having that kind of attitude towards showing that gratitude. Let me come back to what exactly triggered this thing to happen. I incidentally seem to be jobless for quite a long time. I have been trying to accommodate myself. I have been trying to find a proper solution to this, or you know, it's like I've been trying to make sure for myself that you know, I could really be independent. The point of dependency factor has always been in my back of mind. The point over here is, we have many of the youth, young, old, elderly people suffering from this mental trauma. We have some sort of, you know, stagnation. When I say stagnation, our mind gets stagnated at that level. Unfortunately, not everyone are able to come out of it. A few of them are coming out of it. Only a few of them. And by the time they come out of it, it would be a hard time for them to really handle that kind of pressure. At the same time, the kind of mental thrust or mental pressure that he or she holds by the time, it gets succumbed to a situation where he or she thinks, yes, this is my way of life. The point over here is, we people are suffering from this cognitive thinking. Why this cognition happens at first place? Why? In the last 25 years, I have been suffering from this cognitive thought process. If this thing happens, let me do this. If this thing happens, let me do this. Let's think about A, B, C plan, D plan. Everything fails. We think that, yes, I am done with. I am over. To my luck or to my good deeds, I have very good people who are helping me out. Nevertheless, I need to show gratitude towards them as well as gratitude and empathy towards my thought process as well. At times I fail to, you know, engulf or think about it from the existence and exigency point of view. This human consciousness incidentally has gone to a very larger extent, believe me. We often think that, if I try to help someone, we come up with one expectation that he or she will understand and he or she will do it. Unfortunately, when you do not meet that, some sort of insecurity feeling starts within yourself when you get enraged. Enraged in the sense you tend to be like, this guy does not hear. Why should we waste our time in him? My question was always, why this? This has been happening with me for quite a long time. I was a bit insecure. In fact, not bit. I am really insecure. I have been staying in a remote place doing these recordings and looking for what you call financial improvisation. Sad, but unfortunately I am not able to really get through that point. I tried to show to astrologers. They say 2024, 2022, 2025, this thing will happen, that thing will happen. Someone told by 2000 you will go to abroad. My abroad chances got lost, three lost. My family got totally demolished. I tried to save everything. I tried to do everything. I tried to, in a way, like, save others' life as well as my life, which I could not. This is one of the pathetic situations that every one of us faces. Though I have been practicing meditation and yoga, now I understood where exactly things go wrong. There are three processes that happen: conscious, subconscious, and semi-conscious mind, wherein things start programming. They get programmed as and when things happen. The fun part is, every individual is unique at his own level. Whether it is parents, whether it is co-brother, whether it is sister, whether it is relations, whatever it is. Here there is no lineage, there is no line that divides. Irrespective of your relationship, every individual, whoever is born, will have some purpose. That purpose, to know that purpose, one need to perceive. One need to really go through these hardships, which, however, if one is trying to explain, he or she may not understand, he or she will not understand. Absolutely, there is no necessity for everyone to understand this. This includes even parents, sisters, brothers, co-brothers, or taking help from someone. Incidentally, here is where we go wrong, every one of us. We have some kind of expectancy that expectancy ratio, if we really look at, we keep it 100% or 200% or 300%. And with their own limitations they do. At the same time, the expectancy of the gratitude or that he or she will be hearing will start happening, will get programmed. This I have been experiencing for a longer time, because I was depending on various factors. Because wherever I go, things don't happen. I get depressed. I wanted to do something and things don't happen. And here is where we again fall back. I started questioning to myself, what really is that one thing that I can do to convince people about this? Is there something that I could do to convince them? Is there a necessity for me to convince my actions? Irrespective of whether I am going on a negative side or the positive side. Forget about that part. The one very basic point which I always used to concentrate was, do positive things that could be helpful for the society as well as you. Period. Which unfortunately I'm not able to explain. I was really getting forced to understand this phenomena or the concept behind this. In my research of music and dance, which really helped me to understand how does subconscious and conscious and semi-subconscious and semi-conscious state of mind works. At the same time, trying to do the scientific analysis, the scientific study, what really happens from the science point of view, meaning from the genetical point of view, from the genealogical point of view. And I was trying to understand from the astrological point of view. Astrology, most of us think that they are accurate enough, but unfortunately, ladies and gentlemen, to an extent they are accurate, but it doesn't really help one and all. As I see that universal expansion is happening now and then like that. We see stars growing. They have gone to now quadrillions. When I say quadrillions, you can't really count. Because when you were born, when I was born, maybe I would have had a few stars. At the same time, the 12 houses which we are talking about, maybe 14 houses. We have many planets coming up. We have many galaxies coming up. We have billions and trillions of galaxies across universe. then how do you rely on astrology or whatever it is? This indirectly affecting the human existence. This human existence, to this date, till date, there is a debate going on. From where this human individual is born, does he really exist? He or she really exists? Or existed? Yes, definitely he exists, because I am speaking, because I am existing. It's a very crucial point which one needs to understand. At the same time, is this human being having that energy, so-called soul, after it leaves the body, where does it go? Will that get unified with the stars, suns, moons of the planets? Again, we talk about moon. We are talking about one moon today. As per astrology, Chandra, how many Chandras are there? How many stars are there? We are talking about 26 stars. There are more than 26 stars. Countless, billions. If this is the case, is human existence having that credibility? Is what that comes to my mind. Human exigency. When I talk about human exigency, exi plus gency. Existence plus generations. Why am I talking about exigency factor? When you don't know, after you leaving this body, where it goes, at an exigency level, why are we having that expectation? Why is that one needs to convince, and why is that one gets angry? Angry, or one gets depressed, one falls in sorrow, one goes, one dies, one commits suicide, one does this, one does that. The reason for doing this video was, I have been trying to convince people till date, not even convincing. I have been trying to explain them the very base level that, you know, I am doing for this purpose and I need this. I always struggled hard to explain them why this thing I am doing. But none of them are ready to accept that. And like me, there are many of the people who are struggling hard to find this very point. It's a very minute point. It's a very simple point. It's a very, 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 very simple point which one needs to understand. Today, our human individuals are so very dependent on the technological advancement or technical know-how that the genetical science or medical science or the scientific sciences have been evolving now and then like that. Nobody is able to assess that. due to which there is lot of confusion happening. If we go back to Nasadeya Sukta or Hiranyagarbha Sukta, it has a very much base level study. Upanishads sent Upavedas, and that is why Bharata had told the subjective and objective the subjective and objective understanding of the existence of the universe of or the individual is subjective to the changes of the universal facts. How do you explain that? And my only concern to this day, to this date, is that why are we comparing with the monetary aspect? And this coronavirus, if I really look at, there have been what you call environmental changes happening now and then, and there is the worst of the worst that is going to happen in the coming period, to be honest. We need to get prepared for that. How do we? Is this individual who comes on this earth, like this earth, there are many earths. How does it work about? I see this suffering now and then in every one of us. Our human emotions are taking the twists and turns, the human psyche getting into psycho plus eology, psycheology, or they say psychology, but I prefer saying psyche plus eology. We are getting various theories, there are various debates happening. And the very question of when this body which is speaking now, so-called Ramachandra who is speaking now, let's say his Atman or his Atma or his soul goes off, he is motionless and he is emotionless, will it be speaking? Then why this convincing aspect that is coming up? Can we think beyond a point of this? Can we think beyond a point of this? It's a very hard concept, which I have learnt it off late. After my 25 years of, 25 years of struggles, is there something that we could do or we could think about it? Let's not talk about psychologists, let's not talk about psychiatrists, let's not talk about, sorry about that. Let's not talk about all of this. What is it that we are trying to see in a human being as a whole? Why are we not trying to understand? Is what is my question. Definitely, yes. Every one of us has his or her own points there. Why this struggle? Why this tussle between, I would say tussle, between the human mind and the human psyche that is happening at a subconscious level? Is there something that we could grow? By and large, I'm not being harsh. At the same time, I do not want to convince, or I do not want to, you know, give explanation that this is the reason why I did this and these are the reasons why these actions have had happened. On the other hand, on contrary, we have that, you know, we think that everything is in our hands. Every one of us suffer from this. That expectation part has always been a key concept or key aspect which has really affected people. I do not have anything to convince to anyone for my actions or whatever that is happening or happened or did happen. Everything had to happen as per pre-recorded thing, which has to be really understood. I don't know if people can take this, or a broad-minded person can understand this. I don't have any other way to convince. Let's try understanding the human psyche. Psyche plus etiology, psychology. Genesis. Genetical plus systematic study of the human mind, or the human being as an individual. Genesis. Exigency. Existence plus genesis behind the happenings. Exigency. Existence. The very point of individuals existing in the universe, why he or she is coming, plus the trance or the phase, the trance phase where things happen. Existence. How do you fill that vacuum? It's $1,000 billion question. Like me, there are many of them who are suffering with this syndrome. I had to do this video for a simple reason for this. Think about it. I don't want people to, you know, mistake me for this. I'm not here to convince anyone. I'm not convincing on my acts, because I didn't do anything wrong. Why this, you know, consistent, persisting attitude of thinking happening in the human mind? Why is my question. Why are you forcing on the people? Think about it, ladies and gentlemen. It's high time. Our universe is expanding. The conscious and subconscious or semi-conscious or conscious state of mind may go. Everything is expanding. Think about it. It's a $1,000 billion question. Have a nice day ahead. I conclude this video with a positive note. Stay blessed. Have a blissful life. May the Guru's grace be with all. Have a nice day ahead.